Welcome back, dear students. Hope you all are doing well. Today, we are going to learn about a new topic. Let me show you something. Do you understand what is this? Yes, this is the model of pyramid. Do you know where we can see these pyramids? It's in Egypt. So, today, we are going to learn the Egyptian civilization. Now, do you know where is Egypt situated? Can you locate it on this world map? Yes, it's in Africa. Ancient Egypt stretched as far north as modern-day Syria, as far south as today's Sudan. But long before was an empire. Ancient Egypt was a series of small independent city-states that bloomed along North Africa's Nile River. The city-states were divided into two regions and named according to the flow of the Nile. Upper Egypt in the south, which was upstreams, and the Lower Egypt in the north, which was downstream. The Mediterranean Sea lies to the north of Egypt. The desert provided natural protection against foreign invaders, and the early Egyptian settlers enjoyed many years of freedom from attack, during which they could build a society of their own. The River Nile was the lifeblood of ancient Egypt. Every year, the river overflowed and deposited rich black soil along each bank. The Nile also provide water for irrigation and served as ancient Egypt's main transportation route. In 440 BC, the Greek historian Herodotus called Egypt the gift of the Nile, an expression that people use till date. The growth of the ancient Egyptian civilization was powered by the religious belief that the survival of the preserved dead body was a guarantee of life beyond death. The practice of preserving the body of the dead prevailed in Egypt. A corpse preserved thus is called a mummy. Pyramids were tombs where the mummies were preserved. It inspired the ancient Egyptians to build magnificent temples, tombs, and monuments. They remain as evidence for the excessive use of labor and wealth. Students, this is the diary entry of the archaeologist Howard Carter. He is the person who unearthed the mummy of Tutankhamun. Tutankhamun was a king of ancient Egypt. He is the first mummy to be CT scanned. The kings of Egypt were known as Pharaoh. Upper and Lower Egypt were united in 3100 BC when King Menes of Upper Egypt conquered Lower Egypt and founded the national capital on Memphis. The Vase of Menes, a 2 feet high palette, date back to 3100 BC, and it perhaps is the earliest record of Egyptian hieroglyphic writing. It depicts the struggle of King Menes to conquer Lower Egypt, where he is clawing an enemy. King Menes also established the first Egyptian dynasty which followed a series of rulers in the same family. The reigning king was supposed to be the incarnation of the falcon-headed sky god Horus, and hence divine. Hieroglyphic means sacred writing. It is called so because at first the written language was only used for religious work. The hieroglyphic system uses pictorial signs to represent ideas and sounds. Each sign represents an object or an associated idea or a word with a similar sound. The Egyptians also discovered a writing surface called the papyrus. Papyrus is the origin of the English word paper, and the papyrus plant is the river breed. Their advancement in the field of mathematics is also significant. They could calculate the area of triangles and rectangles. The Egyptians also attained amazing advancement in the field of science. They formulated a solar calendar. As per this calendar, a year had 365 days. A year was divided into 12 months of 30 days each. The remaining 5 days were set aside for celebrations. To determine time, they made sundial, a clock that tells time by the shadow cast by the sun, and water clock that works on water current. The Egyptians were also skillful in sculpture. It is evident from the Sphinx, a statue with lion's body and human head. Hope you understood what we learned today. See you in the next class. Thank you and take care.